Hi guys, how y'all doing? My name is Jose Mata. I work for Walmart, 949 store, Woodland. The reason I joined this this movement was because I got curious about when I was on my training, they call it, last July. I got this anti-union videos and stuff, so they's like, you know what? You want to have people approaching you, trying to get you to join this movement and all that. And I was like, okay, hold on. Why are you all so worried about this movement? Why are you so worried about? They might be doing something good. So it took me a while to actually find out, you know, who was the old Walmart. As soon as they approached me, I was like, you know what? I'm down. I was trying just to change. I see all the changes that need to be done at Walmart, all the disrespect. And back then, we had plenty of people to work. Nowadays, we don't have that many people working for us. So now one person has to cover two or three departments. And then if you finish, you have to go help other people. So it's kind of like understaffed right now. So back then, I see that those changes, they had to be done. So before, when I had problems on my work, previous works, I didn't have any options. I didn't have any backup. Now, I felt like I wasn't alone and I could do something. That's the reason why I joined. And I'm just trying to do the best I can to have this big company better for everybody. Better, like we said, if we change Walmart, we're going to change America. We're going to change everything. It's going to be better for them. It's going to be better for us. It's going to be better for everybody. And that's basically the reason I really joined. I really never had problems with them. I have a little background experience in management. So I knew how to deal with them, kind of like there, but then I knew I was not going to be able to do it by myself. Therefore, I'm here.
Hello, everybody. My name is Cherie, and I'm an employee for Kroger and a member of Union Local 1000, UFCW 1000. The reason why I got involved with starting with our Walmart, first of all, we had contract negotiations in our store. And one of our union reps came to me and was like, you know, you should come to the meeting. And I told her, I was like, no, I'm not going to come. And then she looked at me, she said, no, you're going to come to the meeting. I'll be at your house to pick you up. So, you know, I went in and was just listening to them negotiate and, you know, pretty much trying to take everything, take our health care, take our pay or raises, stop the raises, take our 401k, pension, everything. They didn't want to give us nothing, you know, and then the little that they did want to give us, you know, for what they wanted from us is not worth it. And I mean, it made me feel like, you know, it really made me feel bad because I go to work every day and I give my all, 100% to them, and you don't want to pay me for it. So I feel like, you know, when I started working with Walmart, I was like, they're me. You know, these people are just like me. They have family, they have children like I do. You know, why not, you know, help these people get what I have? And, you know, before, I really didn't care. I'm sorry to say it. I didn't care about you, you know. I didn't have problems at work. I didn't anything. I didn't really, you know. But now I see everything that's been done for me because of the union and because of, you know, I have people that stand with me and fight for things for me, you know, and I'm grateful now. Before, I didn't know. And so, you know, it just really didn't matter. And so I love what I do now because I can educate people and show them what coming together can get you and what working together and having a backbone. You know, I can't say a backbone, but, you know, someone to stand beside you and say, you know, we're not going to allow this to happen to you. You know, even though it doesn't have anything to do with them, they still care. You know, that feels good, and that's what I want for Walmart. Because, I mean, I work for Kroger, and they don't care about us, and they don't have half the money Walmart has. So, you know, that's just how I feel.
Stand up. is about more than Walmart. It's going to change the country. The work you're doing is so important to every worker in this country. None of us are alone on our jobs. What happens at Walmart affects Cherie on her job at Kroger. It affects everybody in retail, and it affects everybody outside of retail, too. We know that none of us are alone, and that it's going to take solidarity to make the kind of changes and workers from all workplaces. So I wanted to take a few minutes and invite Linda up to say a few words about the workers at American Airlines who have been fighting to keep their good jobs, and about how that ties in with what we're doing here.
Good evening. Thanks for having me here. I really appreciate it. I got an email from my brother, Tim McEnany, a couple of weeks ago about this. And I am aware of the Walmart struggle. I appreciate each and every one of you and the job you do. I've been an employee with American Airlines for 26 years. In that, I've also been a transport workers union member for 26 years next month. I'm blessed. I can't argue. I still have a contract in place, even with all the negative that you've heard in the news. I have a contract in place. I have someone standing in court for me instead of American Airlines just getting to write anything they want and do away with everything they want to. They want to see the unions divided, and they want us to break up. They want us disbanded because that gives them power. Now, saying that, yes, I'm grateful for my job. I kind of came across, and I do organizing for Transport Workers Union now. And the last 5 years have been the biggest education of my 49 years of life. Had a great education in Oklahoma, came to Texas, and I got a bigger education. I found out how hard it was to organize here, how hard it is to talk to people here, how people think I can do this by myself. Ooh, are you really union? You're union? You get those looks all the time at work. You're afraid to talk about it at Walmart. So I had shirts made up for a committee, and that committee is called the Air Transport ATD Working Women's Committee from our union. And what the shirt says is "Got Union" with a question mark. The reason we did it, we wanted a quiet way to walk into Walmart and show that we're union and show support. I guess the advice I want to give you, even when the tough days happen, the struggles are going to happen in a union, the struggles are going to happen outside of a union, but I'll tell you what we've let happen, we can kind of blame ourselves, because we've let our own worth go with corporate America telling us what we're worth. Do you understand? So if you don't stand up right now and challenge each other, challenge your coworkers in a respectful way to come to meetings and talk, what we do today as workers is going to tell on us 20 years from now. You've got to see that. You know, unions, when you go union, it's not going to happen right away. It's not a magic wand. You're the union. Do not let a company tell you, those union guys over there, they just want your dues money. Well, they just don't care. They're just making money because they're losing members every year. You're going to hear everything out there. Challenge it. Don't walk away. Don't walk away from the best thing. I have 5 sons. The reason I raised them with medical benefits, I had sick time, vacation, I have everything that I need with American Airlines and my union. The reason I had it was because of the TWU. The reason you're going to have it is because the union that's fighting for you, they're not just fighting for you because they want your dues money. They care about workers' rights. So break it down to your coworkers, and what you need to tell them is we are simply workers helping workers. It's up to you. It's not up to me. But we can all do this together. God bless. Stay involved in supporting our Walmart in this
So I'm going to ask the Walmart associates to stand back up again. And so now I'm going to ask everybody else who's in this fight with them to stand up with them.
Yes.
Solidarity forever.